This guy, Shahid or Shahid, I don't even bother learning what his name is, Bolson, who's also had this huge rise in popularity. Why, I wonder? How? Why? The same with Faris Hamadi. How are these no talent hacks so popular? Is it, you know, fake followers? What's going on? So let's see what Bolson, like maybe some of you don't even know about this guy. He literally came out of nowhere, as you're saying in the comments. And what is his message? I think you might be surprised. This is a video he released last week, I think. This is a very recent video.
Is doing has been catastrophically bad for Israel. It's put them in such a weak position that.
So what Israel has done has been catastrophically bad for them, for Israel itself.
That's putting the Gulf in a very advantageous position with regards to the economic conquest of Israel that will come in the form of so-called normalization.
Economic conquest that comes from so-called normalization. Oh, the Gulf countries, Saudi, UAE, they're ready for economic conquest of Israel.
Which is just, again, always with the euphemisms. So
normalization is just a euphemism for conquest. You know, when Saudi and the UAE want to normalize with Israel, it's just a euphemism. On the down low, we know it's actually conquest of Israel. Israel doesn't realize it. This 4D chess that Saudi and UAE are playing and Morocco is playing by normalizing.
When, and it's not a matter of if, but when the Gulf countries, the Arab countries, the Muslim countries economically conquer Israel, they will call it normalization. Because they can't accept, they can't acknowledge what it really is. It will be the economic conquest of Israel, and they're in the weakest position that they've ever been in. You know,
economic conquest
since the beginning of that satanic project, and they're just making it worse for themselves. With every day that this genocide continues, they are dismantling their own economy. They're dismantling their own ability to resist economic conquest by the Arabs.
Look how shifty his eyes are. His eyes keep shifting because he knows what he's saying is complete BS. We're going to economically conquer Israel. That satanic genocidal state, we're going to conquer them economically by normalizing with them and giving them everything they want. We're going to economically conquer the satanic state by doing everything that they want. Like, who falls for this? Like, unfortunately, there are many. There are many Muslims who, I don't know why, it's like very plausible. They're not maybe listening very carefully. They just hear Israel is satanic and they go, oh, that means that this is our friend, pro-Palestinian activist Shahid Bolson. Maybe, like, but he's pushing for normalization. He's advocating normalization with Israel, which is exactly what Israel has been wanting and pushing for. For since its entire existence, basically, to normalize with its surrounding neighbors in order to neutralize any kind of threat against them so that they can continue to genocide and continue to ethnically cleanse and basically secure their illegitimate occupation state without contest from any of the surrounding Arab countries in the Middle East. That's what Israel wants. That's what normalization means. But this spin doctor, this clown says, oh, this is actually economic conquest. This is how we get rid of this Israeli terror, satanic states, by normalizing with them and opening diplomatic relations. So, Dajjal, you know, this is the plain reality. The plain reality is here and you're just flipping it. And you're pretending like you haven't flipped it. So, subhanAllah. People fall for this. People are falling for this guy. We'll have more on this guy. Don't worry about that. Inshallah, you know, if Allah gives me life and this channel is still up, we're going to talk more about this operation, this psyop, and, you know, his videos where, you know, looking around shifty-eyed, pretending like he's a serious intellectual, like, oh, yeah, we're going to dive deeper into his grift, but...
Alhamdulillah.
والحمد لله. حمد لله for normalization with Israel. حمد لله. So do you guys know the background of Shahid Bolson? Like, are you aware? So maybe some of you are not aware of his background. If it weren't enough to like just listen to what he's saying and know that he is just an agent, if you know his background, then it's, you know, beyond dispute. So here's another pro-normalization from October 23rd. So very shortly after October 7th. He says, there's no way around this fact. Without normalization, you're basically guaranteeing that Israel will only ever be accountable to the U.S. and the Arabs and Muslims will never have any leverage. You have to normalize with Israel. If you want to control Israel and you want to conquer Israel, you have to give them everything that they want. You have to just give them billions of dollars in economic ties. You know, that's the only way. Part of why you're against this is hatred for Israel. Oh, justified. Thanks, Bolsonaro, for letting us know that that's justified. And the other part is hatred of our own regimes, which I have argued time and again is only in the interests of the West. So if you have any kind of qualms with the Gulf states, that means you are aligned with the West. You're basically an agent of the West. Look at how he twists it. Perhaps you can start to understand how and why that is. Your stance is nothing but guaranteeing Western hegemony and Muslim helplessness, but you call that the morally correct position. You think that it's morally correct to boycott Israel, boycott Starbucks, boycott McDonald's, isolate Israel. You think that that's actually going to work and that's morally correct? Wrong. What's actually correct is to give Israel billions of dollars, diplomatically build ties with them, build an embassy in your country for Israel. That's what normalization means. That's how you actually defeat the Zionists, not boycott. And, you know, he has to get in there, you know, and support for the regimes. You know, our regimes, you have to support them. They're geniuses. They're playing 4D chess in order to economically conquer Israel. So, okay, Shahid Bolson's background. Did you know this? He was on death row. Shahid Bolson's troubled road to Sharjah's death row. The man who killed a German engineer he met online in 2006 and briefly escaped from prison awaits an appeal court decision on whether he will be executed. So he killed a German engineer while he's in the UAE. He's on death row to be executed. Somehow he escapes briefly, because that's a thing when you're on death row, you can just, you know, pop out and escape. But then he was brought back into prison to be executed, and then he's released. And then he's released from... How does that happen? Let's read more about this amazing turn of events. You know, they need to make a movie about this guy. So here's the background. Web of deceit, sex, and terror. Sharjah. Investigation into the murder of a German man who had disappeared in June last year has revealed a complicated web of sex, deceit, and wild claims of terror financing. The decomposed body of Martin Herbert Steiner, a 48-year-old, that's the German engineer, was found after 15 days by police, stuffed in a suitcase and dumped along the Dubai Hatta Road. So Bolson murdered basically this German engineer at his apartment, stuffed the body into a suitcase and tried to dump that body, or he did dump that body at the side of a road in the desert. Then he tries to escape, but not before using that engineer's credit card to buy $20,000 worth of electronics. So he used the guy's credit card, this German engineer, he's a tourist. He uses the credit card after killing him for $20,000 in goods and then tries to escape the country. This is Bolson. This is the amazing mind, political mind that so many, unfortunately, are listening to. So then, okay, that's one article. Okay, then here is more details. Two people were later arrested. Shahid Polis, I guess, is another name. Like, he has many names that he goes by. Not Shady, of course, but Shahid Polis is another one. An American in his mid-30s has been charged with premeditated murder, while his Ethiopian partner, Fozia, is being charged with aiding and abetting the crime. theft, and having an illicit affair. Steiner's relatives are calling for the death sentence against the American suspect, who has been seeking the family's pardon, according to his lawyer. The victim's family in Germany rejected the appeal. The plea. The Sharjah Sharia Court of First Instance, which was seeking the parents' pardon on the suspect's behalf, will issue its verdict soon. According to details obtained by Gulf News, Shahid Bolson, a convert to Islam, entered the country on a visit visa using a forged British passport. Yeah, that's a normal thing, to just have a forged British passport that's authentic enough for you to get into another country like the UAE. He launched a website which promoted sex with men and women. He shaved his beard and posed as a gay person on the website. The Ethiopian woman Fozia contacted police. Shahid, after reading a newspaper advertisement for a housemaid, they started an affair and she moved to live with him. The suspect posted Fozia's picture on his website, describing her as a woman from the Middle East offering sex for money. Oh yeah, this is all standard stuff. This is what tourists to the UAE do all the time. Okay, so then this is the Denver Post. Okay, so anyway, this is after he gets out of prison. So he's on death row for murdering this German tourist, luring him to his house by basically offering prostitution through a website, posing as a gay man to lure this engineer. Then what does happen? How does the crime actually take place? The engineer was suffocated through chloroform. Like, basically, there is a chloroform rag put over his mouth and he died. And Shahid stuffed him in a suitcase and threw it in the desert. And then went on a shopping spree. Now, how did he get out of prison? How did the UAE let him out? Don't know. And this is something that when Shahid is asked, or Shahid, whatever, when he's asked, how did you get out of prison? His explanation is what? Oh, well, I just told them my side of the story. It was just an accident. It was an accident. It was an accident. How can smothering someone with chloroform be an accident? It has to be premeditated. Like, people don't usually have chloroform sitting on their kitchen counters. Like, what kind of accident is this, Shahid? Doesn't explain. So, according to Shahid, what happened, and he has videos on this explaining, like, what happened, the true story. Like, oh, the judges heard this and the UAE and said, oh, yeah, makes complete sense. And they just let him go. They just let him go, apparently. But what happened, according to him, is that, oh, you lured, basically, Shahid was so disgusted by these Europeans coming to the UAE and using prostitutes. He was so excited that he set up a trap to trap these tourists. So he created, that's why he created a website to trap these Europeans. So the Europeans come to his house, and then the plan was to just tie him up and do what? Don't know. Just tie him up, and then when that German tourist came to his place seeking prostitution, things got rough. A fight broke out, and then Shahid accidentally smothered him with chloroform. Like, do you know what chloroform is? Like, how in a scuffle or a fight are you reaching and able to get the chloroform and put it in someone's mouth? That's not an accident. That's not like, it's not like he tripped and fell and knocked his head and bled out. Okay, that's more plausible. Like, oh, there's a tussle and then you trip and fall and then he gets his head broken. Like, okay, that's plausible. But chloroform over the mouth? That's not an accident. So according to Bolson, it's completely innocent. I was just trying to fight prostitution by pretending to be a gay prostitute myself. Subhanallah. So who falls for this? Apparently a lot of people. Apparently a lot of people, because when I post about this on my ex account, you have these fanboys. Like, even, like, okay, maybe you can understand how someone like Yasser Qadi or Omar Suleiman or whoever, they have these fanboys. Because, yeah, Yasser Qadi is a reformist and puts out all kinds of trash, but he does have some Islamic content. He does inspire people with Quran or with Hadith. Omar Suleiman, the same thing. He does have inspirational things that you can get it, like why someone likes Omar Suleiman. I get that. I understand. But Shahid Bolson, like, how does he have fanboys? Like, what redeeming qualities is there? Is it because he's like putting his hand here and like talking like he's an intellectual? Like, is that like so amazing for some of these people? Like, wow. Wow, he's saying some deep things. Oh, normalization means economic conquest of Israel. Wow. What is redeeming? Like, is he inspiring you? Is he like, I don't get it. But so then what happens? So magically, Mr. Bolson is out of prison. He escapes death row. Does he retire, you know, to some other country to live the rest of his life, thankful that he's escaped death, that he's cheated death, he's gotten away with murder, he just retires and lives a quiet life to himself? No, he immediately goes online and starts calling for terrorism. He starts calling for acts of terrorism to be committed in Egypt. And this is so blatant that he gets covered by mainstream American news stories like, or news sites like the Denver Post. Look at this. Boulder's native, because that's where Bolson is originally from, Boulder, Colorado. He's online writing, inciting Egyptian attacks, terror attacks. Oh, see, even back then when he had more hair, his hand is, you know, placed here. Oh, amazing. That's how you know he's an intellectual. He's really thinking deeply when he's calling for terror attacks in Egypt. And at this time, who's the president of Egypt? Morsi, or, and I think at some point even Sisi, actually. Sisi is the president, not Morsi. So Sisi is the president, and he's calling for terror attacks. This is foreign policy. Allah versus KFC, the chicken restaurant. How an unlikely American ideologue is in Egypt's new generation of Islamic militants. So he's like a militant leader calling for terrorism. So why would, you know, how does this serve the interests of the UAE? Well, UAE is who's backing Sisi, and it's in the interests of the UAE if you can have a more muscular police state. And a more muscular Sisi police state is justified because of extremism. Oh, there's these extremists who are calling for bombing KFC and bombing, you know, whatever in our country. So we have to crack down with more surveillance, with a more muscular, we have to basically put in place emergency laws that restrict freedom, that restrict speech, that restrict protest, because we have this terror threat. Shahid Bolson is calling for jihad against us, so we have to crack down. This serves the UAE, this serves Sisi, this serves the power when some clown, you know, goes online and starts advocating for terror attacks. So could it be that that clown is actually on your payroll and is an agent because, he magically escaped your death row in very suspicious circumstances? I wonder. Even the New York Times is covering him. Online, American helps fuel attacks in Egypt. So imagine, like, this guy is actively calling for terror attacks, but he's perfectly fine now. He's online, has a nice platform on YouTube, has a nice profile on X. No consequences, no, you know, prison time, no nothing. Wow, that he's so lucky. He's like the luckiest man alive. Can you believe this? You have brothers who have gotten mixed up because of online. They haven't been calling for terror attacks. They didn't kill anyone. But they just were in the wrong, like, forum online, and they've been, like, locked up for material support for terrorism. We have brothers in America. You have brothers in America who have been subjected to long-term torture, basically, through solitary confinement. Why? Because they went to a gun range, and they were tricked and entrapped by an agent to use a gun that wasn't properly registered under American law. So they got picked up as, oh, this is a training camp for terrorism, and they were locked up and put in the slammer in a dungeon for over a decade, tortured, basically, psychological torture. But Shahid Bolson is so lucky that he can openly, online, advocate for terror attacks, and the man's free as a bird. No problem. Have your YouTube account, have your X profile, you know, do your videos with your hand on your chin, and no problem. SubhanAllah. So nothing shady about any of this. Nothing shady or questionable. So believe it or not. Oh, here's another article from the Telegraph. Vodafone and KFC, an Egyptian Islamist new hit list inspired by American Muslim convert. Shahid Bolson, born Shannon Morris, served time in Dubai for killing a German businessman and hiding his body in a suitcase. Now he inspires young radicalized Egyptians with online calls for action. So yeah, nothing questionable or shady about any of this. He served time in Dubai for killing a German. Yeah, that's the way that the legal system works. You just serve time for murder. And it wasn't even like long. It was less than 7 years. And then magically Shahid Bolson comes out and he's the biggest advocate of the UAE and Saudi. He's the biggest fan and he's also somehow the biggest proponent of normalization with Israel, which is what these governments want. Wow, what a amazing coincidence. From the luckiest man alive, the luckiest online extremist alive, Shahid. So anyway, this, believe it or not, everything that I've talked about is just scratching the surface of Shahid Bolson. There's like so much, and we'll have more segments on him in future episodes, inshallah, if I'm alive. But do your, you know, just look him up if you're too curious. But we're just scratching the surface. Like, you could really make a movie about this guy and his, you know, life, you know, as this agent. But we'll have more. Like, it's shocking. It's hard to believe that this is real. But unfortunately, you have some Muslims. I don't understand. Like, do you guys not have Google? Like, you can do a Google search. You can, like, plug in a guy's name that comes up and see his background and try to put two and two together. So, but apparently a lot of people can't do that, like, basic research. So I have to cover it on Hayrat Show. But hopefully you learn something about the online dawah. Online dawah with Shahid Bolson and his thousands of followers.
Assalamu alaikum. لا تنسوا الإعجاب بالفيديو والاشتراك في القناة تشجيعا لنا لنستمر بنشر المزيد إن شاء الله.